Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's look at some tips and tricks for using shapes in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, you have the ability to add shapes from a large collection of shapes provided by Apple. But there's some deep functionality in using shapes, so let's take a look. To demonstrate, I'm going to use Pages, but you can do all of this in Numbers and Keynote as well. I'm going to click on Shape here at the top, and the way I add a shape is just by selecting one here. There are all these categories to the left. I can just scroll through them or click on different categories to see different shapes. And then when I want to add a shape, I simply click it and it adds it to the document. Once it's there, I can drag it around to move it. I can grab a corner or edge and resize it. If I move my cursor over one of the side handles here and hold the Command key down, I can rotate it. And then I can set styles here on the right. In Pages under Format, Style, I can set Fill and Border. So for instance, I can set a line border, set it to a color, change its size, change its type. And I can do the same thing here with the fill. I can go and change the fill color to anything I need. So you basically have one line style and color and one fill for the entire shape. But you can break shapes apart if you want to use multiple colors. So with this shape selected, I'm going to go to Format and then Shapes and Lines. And this is where we'll find most of our controls for shapes. And here I can choose Break Apart. And since this is a shape that has different shapes inside it, each one of these rays coming out of the sun is its own shape, it will break all of those apart. Now I can select just the center there and set a fill color for that. And I can select each ray. I'm going to hold the Command key down and select them all. And I can set a different color for the rays. Now if you still want to treat this as one object to move, resize, rotate, and so on, you want to select everything there and then go to Arrange and then Group. And it'll group together all these shapes into a single group. I could always go and ungroup to get back to the individual item there. Now you have more fills available than just a solid color fill. You can switch to a gradient fill, which will go from one color, you see a darker blue, to a lighter blue there. We could change it to something more dramatic, like going from red to blue like that. I could change the angle and reverse the fill if I want. I could also go to Advanced Gradient Fill, where I could add more than just two colors. So I could click here just below the line and add another color. And now you can see I've got three different colors here. I can keep adding different colors and change how the colors change from one to another using all of the controls here on this line. I can also go to a Radial Fill by clicking here. And now you can see I've got a center of the gradient and an outside point. I can drag around the center. I could drag around the outside point, bring it in, and I could add more or fewer colors to the gradient there. You could also do an image fill. So I'll select image fill here and it will use a default pattern. But I could drag and drop any image I want into here. So I'll drag an image just from the Finder right into the spot and you can see it fills it there. I could select how it scales. So I could have it scale to fill, scale to fit, tile, stretch, or original size. If I do something like original size, I could scale it myself. I could also go to Advanced Image Fill, and in addition to doing all that, I can also choose a color to tint the image. Another way to do an image fill is to drag and drop an image into the shape, and that uses the shape as a frame. So now I've got a photo basically embedded into the shape. It's not set as the fill, but as an actual image here, and I can resize it and position it just like I were using any image in Pages, Numbers, or Keynote. You could also add text to any shape. So if you double click in a shape and you start typing, it will add text just as if it's a text box. So I could fill this shape with text here. And you can see it gets a little tricky when you have an unusual shape like this. It works better on a solid shape, something that's more rectangular or just as a single element. But you could do some interesting things with this. For instance, you could fill with a single letter and simply increase the size. And you could change the font to whatever you want, change the color, do things like that. Now if you ever want to combine two shapes into one, you can do that. So I'm going to take this frame shape here and this performing arch shape here, position them where I want them, select both, And now if I go to Format, Shapes and Lines, I can unite the shapes. Now it's a single shape and it will have one color fill and one set of borders. But you could also subtract shapes from one another. So for instance, I could take this heart here. Let's make it a color so it stands out, and I can position it inside this t-shirt shape. Then I could select both of them, go to Format, Shapes and Lines, and Subtract Shapes. And it will use the shape on top to punch a hole in this shape. So you can use that to create new shapes. And now this hole here is transparent, but I could always put one shape on top of another. So I create another shape here that's just a rectangle. Make that fill the space here over the heart, and let's set it to a color. And now I'm going to send it backward so it's behind. So now I've got two different shapes, one on top of the other. I can select them both and I could group them to create a multicolored object. You could also use this technique to invert shapes. So for instance, you have this one here. Let's say I want to have the inverse of this. I'll just use a basic rectangle here. I'll make the rectangle really big and I'll send it to the back. And then I'll shift click to select that bell that's there in the middle. And then I'll do Shapes and Lines and Subtract Shapes. And now I have basically a background that has a hole in it and something else like an image or some text or something can show through in that hole. Now you can also edit shapes. So with this shape selected here, I'll go to Shapes and Lines and I'll make editable. Now I've got all of the endpoints and curve points here that I can drag to alter. So I can do all sorts of different things with the shape. I can even select points and delete them. I'll select these three here, delete, and now I've gotten rid of that part of the shape. Or you could just draw your own from scratch. Click Shape here and then use this Pen tool. And now you can click and put points where you want, click and drag to set something as a curve, and create any kind of shape you want. Connect the first point to the last point like that, and now you can set a fill to fill the shape. And you can continue to edit by dragging the different points here, selecting them or deleting them. Whether you've created the shape on your own or edited an existing shape or combined a couple of shapes together, you can save this as a new shape. So just go to Format, Shapes and Lines, and then select Save to My Shapes. And now you can give it a name. And you find you can use it in other documents as well. Now here are a couple more tips. You can select a shape and copy it. And then as you would expect, you can paste it into other pages, documents, into Numbers, into Keynote. But you can also paste it elsewhere and it will just convert it to an image. So for instance, in Mail here, I can just paste Command V and we'll paste it in and it's just a little PNG image. You can do the same thing in Messages. You can do the same thing anywhere that you can paste an image. And here's one last tip. If you set things up with a fill that you like, with a border that you like, and you want to use that same style for other shapes, you could save it to Styles. Under Format, Style here, you'll see Shape Styles. And if you use the arrows here to move over, you'll see a plus button. You could click plus and it will save that style. So now if I were to add another shape, like a tree here, then I could just go to Style, find that style, select it, and it will apply the same style between these two. This is really great for making your artwork look consistent throughout your document because you can make changes and it will apply to all of them. So I can go back to this apple here, for instance, and say, well, that's not quite the right fill color. I want to do this one. Then I can control click on the style here and say redefine style from selection. When I do that, it's going to tell me that another object uses the style, and I can choose update all objects. And I could see it updates that one. I could have 100 different objects using the style and I just updated them all throughout my entire document. So I hope you found these tips for using shapes in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote useful. Thanks for watching. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.